Merger between Indiabulls Housing Finance and Lakshmi Vilas Bank. If it goes through, it will be India's eighth largest private sector bank. Now, Latha joins us with her take on the proposed merger. Latha, what could be the key factors that will work for and against this deal? It will require regulatory approval, which could take about 6 to 9 months.
Just a little word of history. They had applied in the 2013 round. And only two people, there were about some 20 applicants at that time, and only Bandhan and IDFC had been given the license. What we hear from some of the people who applied is that they were told to hold back. RBI has been conservative, and they will put the rules on tap rules, and at that time, people should apply. That's what apparently they were told. Now, what sources tell us now is that Indiabulls has contacted RBI officials at several levels. More importantly, the LVB board itself has two RBI nominees, nominee directors, and they have the power to veto proposals such as these, and they have not vetoed apparently, because the proposal has gone from the LVB board as well to the exchange. And of course, they say they have the sources say that they have tried to reach out to RBI at various levels. They also say that, this is again an observation of sources, that RBI wants both NBFCs and small private banks to get protected. Small private banks like LVB have just gone through an NPA brush. And NBFCs, housing finance companies in particular, have had gotten a body blow because of the debt market problems. So it is in the interest of the financial sector for RBI as well to render both sides strong. So these are the things that may work in favor. Now, what may work against the deal? Well, firstly, the Reserve Bank has always steered clear of giving license to conglomerates. Now, they could consider Indiabulls a conglomerate. It has wings like real estate, which not always are sectors that RBI prefers. And if you can give an Indiabulls conglomerate a license, will not there be an AV Birla Group which will ask for a license? They also have AB Capital. Will not there be others in the line, like the Mittals, the Tatas? So RBI will have to make a conscious call whether it will give license to conglomerates and whether it will make that beginning. So it's a policy decision that it will have to take, a decision which successive RBI governors have steered clear of and said no to conglomerates. And it's usually one of the practices in many countries not to give it to conglomerates. As well, governments and regulators, although they're usually at loggerheads, understand one thing. Once you take the depositor's money, you are actually underwriting it with the taxpayer's money. Nowhere in the world is a scheduled commercial bank allowed to go under, or rather in most countries. You remember Global Trust Bank in our own country, remember Northern Rock in the United Kingdom. Once you give a banking license, basically a depositor, the most unsavvy saver, is giving his money uncollateralized for anything as less as 4%, because he has faith in the sovereign. So the taxpayer is underwriting the depositor's faith. Will the government give that license easily? You may say that, these are powerful groups and they would have had chats with the governments and the regulators. But governments and regulators in India in the past 75 years, for all the cronyism you can accuse governments of, have always been on the same page. I must think before I put the fiscal might behind a bank. That thought, that debate will definitely happen before this license is granted.